Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. We say together, Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment, and the second is like, namely this, Thou shalt love thy neighbour as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us. Incline our hearts to keep this law. Let us pray. Almighty God, who hast given us thine only begotten Son to take our nature upon him, and as at this time to be born of a pure virgin, grant that we, being regenerate and made thy children by adoption and grace, may daily be renewed by thy Holy Spirit, through the same our Lord Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the same Spirit, ever one God, world without end. Amen. Please be seated for the reading. The reading appointed for the epistle is written in the first chapter of the letter to the Hebrews, beginning at the first verse. God, who at sundry times and in divers manners spake in times past unto the fathers by the prophets, hath in these last days spoken unto us by his Son, whom he hath appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the worlds, who, being the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person, and upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down on the right hand of the majesty on high, being made so much better than the angels, as he hath by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. For unto which of the angels said he at any time, Thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee? And again, I will be to him a father, and he shall be to me a son. And again, when he bringeth in the first begotten into the world, he saith, And let all the angels of God worship him. And of the angels, he saith, Who maketh his angels spirits and his ministers a flame of fire. But unto the Son, he saith, Thy throne, O God, is forever and ever. A scepter of righteousness is the scepter of thy kingdom. Thou hast loved righteousness and hated iniquity. Therefore God, even thy God, hath anointed thee with the oil of gladness above thy fellows. And thou, Lord, in the beginning hast laid the foundations of the earth, and the heavens are the work of thine hands. They shall perish, but thou remainest, and they all shall wax old as doth a garment, and as a vesture shalt thou fold them up, and they shall be changed. But thou art the same, and thy years shall not fail. Here endeth the epistle. The Holy Gospel is written in the first chapter of the Gospel according to St. John, beginning at the first verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. This is the Gospel of the Lord. So here we are on Christmas morning, thinking about shepherds and wise men and the baby in a manger. And Holy Mother Church, in her wisdom, has given us two chunks of extremely chewy theological writing to ponder. But imagine yourself for the moment as a first century Jewish person, or a Christian, perhaps, who has explored the Old Testament. And imagine yourself hearing, for the very first time, the beginning of our gospel. In the beginning. En arche, in Greek, which is the very same as the beginning of the book of Genesis, which you probably knew in Greek as well. En arche. You cannot possibly not immediately be transported back, as St. John intends, to the very beginning of all things, to the creation of the world. But where in Genesis we have, in the beginning, God, en arche, hotheos, in John we have, in the beginning, the Word, en arche, hologos. And that word logos, which we translate as word, in the beginning was the word, doesn't just mean word in the sense of a word that we use in a sentence like giraffe or anti-disestablishmentarianism. It means word, thought, mathematics, all that can be rationally used to make sense of the world, speech, language, the things which human minds do, the things which make us rational human beings rather than just animals. All of those things are wrapped up in that word logos, which we translate as word. In the beginning was the Word. In the beginning, when there was only God, there was also with God thought, imagination, those things which make us human were already present from the beginning of all things in and with God in the Word. But St. John wants us not only to think of the beginning of creation, but of the beginning of the life of Jesus Christ. And the Word was made flesh. Now, for us who know this reading so well, that's the bit we're looking forward to. That's the climax. We know it's coming. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we have seen his glory. But for the first hearers, the idea that the Word, the essence of God's mind, could become a human being is kind of scandalous. Certainly to those people who were brought up in the Jewish faith, for those who were brought up studying their Greek philosophers at school. Perhaps not so much for those followers of the state religion who are used to thinking of the emperor as God, but this is something different. This isn't the elevation of a human being to be like God. This is God descending to be in the world that God himself has made and coming as a tiny baby. God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. When I hear those words in Genesis, I think of a huge flood of light, the essence of light, a light so overpowering that it cannot be born. I don't know if you've seen the film Sunshine, about a group of space explorers heading towards the sun. And as they get closer and closer to the sun, the light is so overwhelming that it drives them mad. The brightness is incomprehensible. The light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. But the light of that first Christmas, the light of Jesus Christ, represented by the candle in the middle of our Advent wreath, is a tiny spark, a vulnerable child, entirely dependent on its terrified teenage mother. But from this tiny spark, more candles are lit. My favorite service of the year is at Easter, where a single candle representing Jesus stands in a pitch dark church. And the congregation are all holding candles. This is particularly dramatic in an Orthodox service, where there are lots and lots of people all holding their tall, thin candles. And slowly, from that light, all the other candles are lit until the whole church is ablaze with light. And this is how St. John wants us to think of that "let there be light," that it begins with the Word made flesh. A tiny prick of light in the darkness, which then spreads as we each respond to his light by giving our lives to God in Jesus Christ, by being made God's children by adoption, as the writer of the letter to the Hebrews puts it. We receive the light of Christ and so become part of that light which tumbles through the world, filling it. And there is no place so dark, no situation so black, that the light of Christ cannot illuminate it. There is no situation that feels so beyond our understanding or control that the imagination, that the reason of God cannot bring good things out of it, cannot help us to see the truth where there is only chaos. And so this Christmas, let us pray that we may be overshadowed by the Holy Spirit, that the light which was lit in our baptism may be kindled into flame, that through us light may dawn, a light that darkness cannot overcome. A very happy Christmas to you all. Stand to proclaim the faith of the Church. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary and was made man and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the scriptures and ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. And I look for the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's Church, militant here in earth. We pray for Sarah, our bishop, for all Christians throughout the world, especially for those who are persecuted for their faith. We pray for Pope Francis and all shepherds of Christ's flock. For our friends at St. James Church, Spanish Place, and Hind Street Methodist Church, for the Cathedral of St. John the Baptist in Kagera, Tanzania. Draw us closer together that in our love for one another, the world may see the love of Jesus Christ. We pray for our world, for all places of violence and conflict, for the Ukraine, for the Yemen, for all those fighting overseas or seeking to keep the peace from our own armed forces. We pray for our local government, for our MP, councillors, members of the London Assembly, for all those who seek to serve their fellow human beings, that they may do so with humility and wisdom. We pray for all the medical institutions of our parish, for those places of healing here, the Healing and Counselling Centre and the Marylebone Health Clinic, for King Edward VII Hospital, the London Clinic, the Sherne Clinic and the Cleveland Clinic, London, for members of our congregation as we seek to bring chaplaincy services to those places and especially for Lydia, chaplain of UCLH. We remember in particular all those in those places for whom Christmas is dark and the way forward unclear. We pray for all those who suffer. Amongst those known to us, for Graham, Leah, Ian, Felix, Genevieve, Don, Rosemary, Evelyn, George, Diana, Sally, Boyega, Depot, Jeanette, Joy, Jackie, Myrtle, John, Cicely, Mary, Carol, Bob, Felipe, Vicky, and Hannah. For all those whom we bring on our hearts and those who have none to pray for them. We also pray for the souls of all those who have died, for those whom we love and see no longer, for those who have died this past night, especially for any who died alone or unprepared, and for those the anniversaries of whose deaths occur this week, including Beatrice Lunis, D.K. Onyega, Colin Edwards, Peggy Kemp, John Mark Escobillo, Arthur Goddard, Edith Pearson, Peter Mosling, and Mabel Goulding, that they may be purged of their sins and brought into the light of the heavenly kingdom. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all they that do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also to save and defend all Christian kings, princes, and governors, and especially thy servant Charles, our king, that under him we may be godly and quietly governed. And grant unto his whole council and to all that are put in authority under him that they may truly and indifferently minister justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and curates that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacrament. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and specially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succour all them who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Ye that do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbours, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy ways. Draw near with faith, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, meekly kneeling upon your knees. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to to the honour and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and absolve you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life everlasting, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Saviour Christ saith unto all that truly turn to him. Come unto me, all that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty and everlasting God, because thou didst give Jesus Christ, thine only Son, to be born at this time for us, who by the operation of the Holy Ghost was made very man of the substance of the Virgin Mary, his mother, and that without spot of sin, to make us clean from all sin. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord most high. Amen. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same, Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there by his one oblation of himself once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue, a perpetual memory of that his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. Who, in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he brake it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which are given for you. We pray together. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favour and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of the most precious death and passion of thy dear Son. And we most humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honour and glory, world without end. Stand to say the Gloria. Glory be to God on high, and in earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee. We give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesu Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always.